How about you?
I'll go for the older woman.
Remove that immediately.
Dorian Green, it's a pleasure to do business with you.
Tom Lucas.
Goodness, what an enormous wad.
Them in the building trade. Cash in hand sort of thing.
Really? How wonderful.
You couldn't help me to the van, could you?
You have a van?
Yes, tools and tarpaulins and such like, but we should find some room for it.
Sounds perfect. What man could possibly resist you? Paul, you're a lucky boy. Hi, darling. What do you want?
Well, our phone's on a blink and I need to ring a cab. Is it all right if I borrow yours?
Did Sharon send you round here?
Well, she's down the calf. I'm going to see the family.
OK, but, we'll be quick.
Oh, cheers.
Everything OK?
Yeah.
I've got this bloke coming round, business contact, supplier, and I thought it'd be better if there was two of us here.
Oh, I knew you'd need my help sooner or later. You see, I've got what it takes when it comes to dealing with businessmen.
You were just a little late arriving, dear. I hope you're going to stay.
You know I'm a stayer. I can see flashing blue lights.
That's what they all say. Come on, let's see some sparks as well.
Now look, Dorian, there's a flashing blue light in the street.
Yes, well, the street's outside. We're in here. Why waste the privacy?
Looks like a police light. Next door. Shouldn't we check it out?
Yes, well, we can't go out there half undressed.
But we're not.
Well, if you just stand still for a minute.
We're supposed to be friends of yours.
Friends like those who need a cold shower.
Marcus has been here all night.
What? Oh, no.
Where were you?
When he's too old.
Tracy's on television.
You know, being
husband. Oh, Shane, is she? Right, good job, I've got a tape.
Good. What'd you do that for?
Don't you want to know where I was last night?
Not a lot.
I couldn't go to my mother's. I wouldn't go to that bitch Melanie Fishman's. Couldn't afford to book into a hotel. So I had to spend the night in the spare room of my pathetic brother's pathetic semi and pathetic Collindale. And the baby screaming in the next room. And the pervasive smell of regurgitated baby milk seeping from every wall. Stop trying to confuse me.
Hello? Mrs. Clapper? Sorry to ring so late.
Sit!
No, it's Tracy Stubbs, Dorian's neighbour. No, we're not up late because we're about to go out cat burgling. Dorian, what have you told her? Oh, it was a joke. All right.
Maybe she ain't.
Even you, Sharon, with your deep wellspring of working-class cynicism, are gobsmacked.
Dorian, it's gorgeous.
Damn right it's gorgeous. If £5,000 worth of Hearty Original doesn't shriek gorgeousness, then what is its function?
Oh. Not dressed yet, I see.
Did you go to the restaurant with Roger? Did you suck raspberry what's it off your fingers?
And the rest.
Well, actually, that's why I came round. Roger was so intense and demanding that we never quite made it to the restaurant.
And have a knot on your head, bald, you mucky trollop.
So, I thought maybe we could go there for Sunday lunch.
This is me.
Well, good night then, Dorian.
Oh, Roger, you have something on your lip.
Really, what is it?
Me. Till tomorrow night then, darling.
If the night gets long and lonely, you call me.
Roger the barman. Lovely choice.
This is quite beautiful. I think this is a bit young for you. Dazzling.